Okay, so now we're getting into it. Last time I talked about one of my first anime waifus, which was Jessie from Pokemon. This week it's time to talk about Android 18. Now, this is a character that I have been obsessed with since I was a teenager. She was my second anime waifu, and more than likely my most intense anime crush. Now, when I was in Japan, I went to plenty of arcades, and I talk about that in my arcade haul video, and one of the prizes that I won was this lovely figure of Android 18 herself. The box didn't survive very well in trying to bring it back home to America, but as you can see here, this is the Dragon Ball Z Glitter and Glamorous Android 18. You can see that a little bit better on the top of the box. And yes, while the box is beaten up from bringing it home in my suitcase, it's still lovely. We have a beautiful shot of Android 18 on this side, another wonderful close-up of her brushing her hair beside. Then this shows there's actually two different color variants of her. I actually won the one with the darker shirt. And finally, the shot that you were looking at in the beginning. I used to just obsessively collect pictures of Android 18 when I was in middle school. I would save them and print them and put them all in a book, and I was really big into shipping her with Vegeta for some odd reason. But middle school is far behind me, and now I'm an adult man-child and I can buy and collect expensive figures. I didn't even realize there was tape on these. I'm happy to see that they actually put her inside of an additional box within that box, because these UFO catchers sometimes will allow these figures to drop. But within all of that is our lovely figure. And wow, everything is one piece, which really surprises me. I'm really surprised to see this thing comes in only two pieces. You just get the figure and then the stand. But let's talk about this stand. This is not a stand. This is just a blank piece of plastic with two holes in it. That's terrible. And while I understand that this is an arcade UFO catcher prize, you could at least put a little bit of something on this, maybe a sticker or anything, just something to make it more than just a flesh-colored piece of plastic. But speaking of flesh, let's take a look at her. Because she is indeed made of flesh, because she's an android and she got turned into a human. But that's besides the point. This figure is actually really, really nice. This Glitter and Glamorous set, there's more than one of them, so this is actually the second version of Android 18 that they've done, and goodness, I've gotta say, I absolutely love it. Something about Android 18 I've always loved is her eyes. As simple as they are, something about them is just so striking. That almond shape is just gorgeous, and it looks really good here, even though it's simply printed onto the figure. Or maybe it's a decal, who knows. Either way, it actually looks great. Everything here looks wonderful. The color is actually really nice. It's somewhat muted, but still vibrant enough to be attractive to the eye. I love the little hints of red with the earring and the bracelet. It really helps to add just a little bit of something to distract you while you're looking at her. But speaking of distractions, goodness gracious, this figure is just absolutely stunning. Android 18 has always been one of the more provocative characters, and I do think that this figure is a little bit too busty for her, but I can't complain too much because it's somewhat tasteful in the fact that they're not spilling out of her vest. I'm rather impressed with her legs and the jeans. The texture on them looks pretty good, and all the wrinkles are really well crafted. All the sculpting here is really good, and even that little bit of midriff there is just another wonderful touch that they really didn't even have to do. The feet are a little bit plain. She's just wearing flip-flops, and her toenails aren't painted or anything like that, but I wouldn't expect 18 to do that anyway. One thing I've got to point out is this butt. It's a glorious butt, and if you look, you can kind of see a fracture right in the middle. Hilarious, I know, but ultimately, it leads me to believe that these are actually two halves to one piece, which allowed them to really dig in and make that shape all the more peachy. Still, the vest has that nice denim look to it, lots of wrinkles and texture in there, and her hair is many, many strands that actually looks pretty good. There's really no shading here, and somehow it's still rather effective. And like some other arcade prizes, she's actually a pretty decent size, coming in at just under 9 inches. So with all of that out of the way, how exactly do I feel about this figure? Well, I actually really like her. She's not much of a figure, of course, she is a statue, so there's really only so much you can do with her. The worst things about her happen to be the base is very plain and boring, and there are a few spots on her where I can see imperfections. There's a few marks of molding that could potentially be shaved down, but I don't want to mess anything up, and additionally, there was a spot or two on her of discoloration, of which I was only able to rub off one. That being said, Banpresto seems to make some of the best arcade prizes, and these figures really are nice. Depending on what you spend on it, I'd say it's definitely worth the money. Now, I spent a lot trying to win her, but she easily goes for about $30 on eBay, and I'd say that that's pretty fair. You're getting excellent quality here, especially for that value, and she looks amazing on a shelf, and not too fanservice-y to the fact that she looks inappropriate, so I do like it overall. The only other thing that I would like to see would maybe be a bit more shading. There's really hardly any shading work done on this thing. I'm not sure if there really is any. It seems to just be sculpted in a way that natural shadows seem to do a lot of the work for it. Which is good, I think that's smart and surely cost-effective, but, you know, you can always want more. The Glitter and Glamour set is really nice. I called it glamorous at first, but it's actually just glamour. And yeah, all these characters are incredibly fanservice-y and very sexy, but that's what we like about them, of course. So yeah, if you're into that, then pick up one of these figures from the line. They're definitely pretty nice. I'm gonna give this one a 7 out of 10. There's always room for improvement, and this one isn't perfect, but at the same time, I realize the strengths and weaknesses of it being a cheap arcade prize, so I'm not mad at all. What do you think of Android 18? Do you think she's as pretty as I do? Who was your first anime crush? Why don't you leave a comment below and let me know. If you like this video, make sure to leave a like on the video, and subscribe if you haven't already because I'm always reviewing new figures. I'm gonna link something on screen, and if you have or haven't seen it, why don't you go ahead and click it anyway because it helps my channel. Thanks again so much for watching, have an awesome weekend, and keep on collecting.